Southern Hills Carpet, and they are the ones that received the bid for the carpet of the plunge when they closed, and they are requesting half of their bid up front, and I didn't feel comfortable with just adding it to the claims without having that kind of out there separately for consideration. The total bid is $7,985, and they were requesting a down payment of $3,992.50.
Is there a reason for it? Is the material cost or what?
All Emily said is that they called her today and wanted to know whether they could get 50, or requested that they get 50% down.
Was that in your budget, was it?
It's part of the make not the closing and part of the upgrades that were recommended.
When are we going to get an actual update on the plunge for money?
Whenever you want one.
Well, I guess I might have them next council meeting.
Okay.
All right, the council, we have that bill on here.
No. I don't think it's legal.
It's up to the council one way or the other.
I don't have a problem with it.
They supply us with material, carpet. So they might ask for the have a price for the material. It's normal.
A smaller operation, doesn't have the overhead to purchase some of the things that go on when you're dealing with
local. Can't wait 2 weeks.
We don't know their books, so we don't know what kind of.
If you don't add it, it will wait 2 weeks.
That's what I'm saying. Is it that critical? You do the carpet right now. You can't do this thing legal and just put it on the next agenda and the next bill.
I'm just going off of what the local businessmen.
I think they want to change it when the plunge is shut down and clean the floor.
When is it scheduled to be?
This month. So.
Towards the end of the month here.
Seventeen.
So you can still get on the next.
Well, they have to. They won't be able to order it in until they receive payment.
Tell me exactly the amount.
$3,992.50, which is one half of the bid of $7,985.
I'll make a motion that we pay it.
You got a motion with your claims, sir.
A motion we add that to the claims. 1 second.
I'll second.
Motion second to add that to the order claims amount. Discussion. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no?
No.
Okay, then the current claims will be 64,891.18 plus 39,92.50. Do I have a motion?
We have a motion.
Right. We've got a motion and a second to approve. Any more discussion or questions? If not, I got a motion and a second to approve. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
No.
No. No.
And the accounts payable 2013. We've got $7,577.76. We have a motion to approve that.
Second.
Motion second. Discussion or questions?
I just had one on this. It was the New Rushmore radio. What?
That was ads that were done during December, so it's a payable for 2013.
I got one more question under the Lee and Jackson engineering firm, and we refused to pay that bill month ago because nobody could tell me what it was for, and I see it's back on.
Yep. After review of that, it was the State Aeronautics Commission, in order to close out the grants for the last 2 years, we needed to finalize the environmental review that Cadmus Jackson had started, and they strongly recommended that we allow the old engineering firm to complete that. My concern was that we were doubling up with the new engineering firm, and we were doubling up services for the same thing if we were not. So in order to close out the grant, or at least include this payment in the grant, that was the work that Cadmus Jackson had to do to finalize the environmental review that they've been doing over the last 3 years for the airport.
Okay,
master plan for the airport. What's that? API, what does that stand for yet?
Airport layout plan.
Airport layout plan, thank you. Other ed, sorry. Got two eds tonight.
That's the end of it.
That's the end of Kansas, Jack. That's the end of Kansas, Lee Jackson, yes.
Any other questions or discussion on the bills, council payable 2013? Got a motion and a second to approve. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. And communication from the public. Mike?
Hi, Mike Closer here on behalf of Hot Springs Girls Youth Football and Cheerleading. It's going to be the inaugural season for the program. What this program is it gives kids a chance to have a team atmosphere. So far, we are the last Southern or Northern Hills team to have a team. Grades included in would be the Mighty Mites, which are first and second graders, Junior Pee Wee, which is third and fourth, and then you have the Pee Wee, which is fifth and sixth. It's real football. It's pads. Girls have the options of playing football or cheerleading. The team so far that are included for this year, and this is actually the sixth year, I believe, of the Black Girls Football League, which we're being a part of. When you develop a team, you have to have an NFL mascot. Hot Springs being the Bison, I think the girls was the easiest, closest one we could have the same logo as the high school. Right now, Rapid City actually has four teams per division. Spearfish has two teams per division. Other towns included, Sturgis, Wall, Hill City, Lee, Deadwood, Box Elder, Bellefouche, Blackhawk, and even Custer's second. So if Custer can fill the team, I feel that we have no problem filling the team. With this program, it also makes us more competitive with the almighty Eastern teams that said everybody says Western. Talked to the high school coach, Ben Kramer. He's totally on board with this idea. He's actually on the 500 board that we have. With the league, each player is $185 a kid to play. With that, what they get is they get their helmet, practice pants, but then we still have to buy jerseys, game pants, and the first year is going to be the initial major cost because we have to provide everything that we need for future years that we'll have to pay for each year. It includes tackling dummies, forearm pads, practice jerseys, water coolers, footballs. So the first year is pretty daunting in trying to raise the funds for it. The reason I'm here is I don't believe that each kid should have to pay $185. Most kids in town, I mean, I know if I hire two boys in there, but I can't work $85. Cheerleaders, if a girl wants a cheerlead, it's $110 a girl, and that provides the full uniform. I just think it's a great program. I initially was going to take my boy to Custer and play. Well, then I started hearing him talk, tell stories about my friends and others. 20 of us play recess every day, and they're just obsessed with football. Well, why take our kids down to Custer? Why not have our own program right here where we can have the community involvement? We'll need coaches, we'll need referees, we'll need so many volunteers, and it'll bring the community. And if you've ever watched, you can go on YouTube and watch first and second graders play football, and it's comical. I mean, they blow on each other and they fall over. So the risk of injury is it's no more than soccer, it's no more than skateboarding, it's no more than riding a bicycle down a street and fall. If you need to watch, it'll show you that it's not guys my size running really fast, slamming into each other. They do have weight requirements on it, so if you have a larger kid, he's not going to be your running back, he's going to run a line. So it's not going to be a full head of steam coming at you. The league itself, the Black Hills Youth Football League, puts on a coaching clinic for all the coaches. So they're certified in the Heads Up program, which teaches you to see what you're tackling instead of ramming your head into somebody. It teaches concussion awareness. It's not like when I played, that if you're seeing stars or you're seeing three things, the coach told you to hit them on the middle. It's concussion now, the awareness is huge. Also for the kids, before the season starts, they have a camp for the kids to go to, a couple day camp, where our kids will all be starting out fresh. So a couple day camp, they go up there, learn the basics, come in the season with a good, pretty good base knowledge. As the kids progress, and Hot Springs starts football in sixth grade, Edgemont starts kids in fifth grade. Instead of bringing a kid in fifth or sixth grade, try to teach him the fundamentals of the game. By the time these kids have played this youth football for 2 years, they're gonna know, they're not gonna be thinking out there, they're just gonna be reacting. They don't have to worry about what do I do here, what do I do here. They're gonna have that couple year base under themselves where they're gonna be playing, and it's only gonna help the high school program. The cost estimate that I came up with was for approximately 60 kids. I think we can do that. It's 20 players a team. With the players, they all get the same amount of playing time. There's no, you're better than this one, so you're better than every kid. It's the same amount of playing time. And it's not you put the worst kids at the end. They have to play a certain amount each quarter. So everybody gets the full feel. It's not you the family driving piece to Rapid City to watch the kid play 2 minutes a week. So everybody is involved. The cost estimate I came up with for 60 players, it's $185 a kid, so it'd be $11,100. Some of the other ones put approximately 10 cheerleaders, it'd be about three grade level, be $1,100. Game jerseys, we're looking at, from the research we've done, it's going to be about $30 a piece. Figure that at your 60 kids, so it's about $1,800. Game pants. And the pants that we want to give the kids to make it easier on them is the integrated pants. So you don't have to put the pants in every day. The pads are sewed in, so you just wash the whole thing and no parts of the pieces are lost, which will save us from a longer having to replace them. And then other things that we have to think about are mouthpieces. We have to think about game balls. The estimate on that is game hand practice balls. So if we got 12 balls, four for team, $300. And then the other things that come along, if you've ever been in football, there's so many fine parts that you have to get. The athletic kit, helmet repair kits, coolers, and also with that, when what I was talking about community involvement is another aspect we can do is team moms, where moms are involved with, you bring the snacks for them. We'll have people, being in the profession, I know that certain people have driver's licenses and they want to help that with having helping out drivers that will take kids from their home. So it's just, I can't stress enough how much I think it'll bring the community together. Some of these kids, this might be the only time they ever play football. It's real football, everybody's announced, so you have 6-7 different teams there, 500-600 people sitting there watching these games, get to names are being announced. Might be the only time they ever got names announced. It's going to build confidence. This is the mission statement we came up with. The mission of the Hot Springs Bills will be educational. We hope to implement firmly in the youth the ideas of physical conditioning, good sportsmanship, honesty, loyalty, courage, and respect for authority. With the proper guidance, they will become better adjusted, stronger, happier children, and grow obedient and trustworthy adults. That's all I have for you.
So you're asking us to consider some dollars in budget?
That would be great.
In the summer.
Correct. The season starts August 1st. That's when the first practice is going to happen. Over Labor Day weekend, we have a jamboree where all the teams come together. It's just like 20-minute halves of offense, defense. It's the first weekend after that is the first actual regular season game. There's 7 games for the regular season. If the teams do well enough, they make the playoffs. If they do well enough in the playoffs and they keep winning, they actually go to they have a Super Bowl, and the Super Bowl is on the turf at the school lines. So that'd be quite the thing for the kids to be a part of. So I would appreciate everybody involved so far. Would appreciate anything you guys could help us out with.
Thanks. Thanks, Mike. Mike also, in case you don't know, he coaches high school over at Edgemont, which helps assist him.
Will these teams be traveling teams or playing each other?
They'll be traveling teams. So of all the teams that I listed. Right now, it looks like mostly the games are played at City Christian. Some of the games are even played at O'Hare Stadium and Spearfish. And as soon as we get our feet into the league, we'll be able to have home games.
How much are you taking per child or family?
I would love to see that the kids all they have to do is buy a pair of cleats and come play. We could, depending on how the funding goes, we might have to set a limit of $30 a kid. But families like mine that have two boys, that's $400. That's tough for anybody. That's, the average median income in all the counties is $35.
They carry the insurance.
The league itself has a blanket insurance for us.
Any other sponsors?
Right now, we have one lined up to sponsor the league events. Other ones are in works. Right now, we're just trying to get our final ones set up. So we're actually trying to start doing the fundraising.
I had to buy their cleats and their mouthpieces. You can't reuse mouthpieces.
And there's
cleats.
And with the cleats too, kids that age, they grow so fast that if you outgrow your pair, we'll have a donation box where kids that can't even afford cleats can come through and pick a nice pair. There might be some kids that they can't afford cleats at all during this, and that's why I want to raise more than the actual cost, so that we can go out and buy a kid a pair of cleats if that's all he needs. And they don't have to be fancy, just a pair of cleats. I don't want kids standing out there with tennis shoes on.
Planning on doing any fundraising?
Correct. We've got a few fundraisers. One that numerous people will probably enjoy is a Pie a Cop. We're going to sell raffle tickets. And if you're one of those John, you can throw a pie in my face. So. And we've got a few deputies in City Council. Yeah, so I think that'll raise a few.
Would this be Edgemont?
Correct. Edgemont, Hot Springs, Oryx, any kid that is of age that we're able to play. And the kids that will be playing make sure we have kids going into first and sixth.
Okay. Thanks, Mike.
Right, thank you.
Keep us updated when we get some funding.
Definitely.
All right. If anybody has never seen one of the games, they're unreal. In fact, I went and watched one last year. Probably the best football game I've seen all season.
Better than the one yesterday.
Yeah, right.
I haven't seen a good one recently. Thanks, Mike. Any other communication for the public?
Yeah, I just like to ask for a follow-up to the report that we gave our vision 2020 last summer. We'll see you. Specifically, given the discussions that have been going on in the tourism meetings about cleaning up the city, the downtown area, I'd like us to specifically focus on repairing the streets of people, my clock, and the clock, right last time. But just a general report, there was 11 items. We've already done three or four or five of them, so we've already seen progress. But there's still a few other things that we were looking for the city council to support. We're not going to mind, but if we are, just let me know where we're at. So maybe Monday, or if you think it's a holiday actually, or the next meeting, or whatever is convenient for you guys.
We'll be meeting on Tuesday the next time.
Yeah. So.
Okay. Thanks. Any other questions? About 6 months already, the icon of the hot springs sitting across the street from my motel and the former Wayside Motel. Maybe somebody can explain what's over there. Is it an outhouse or bus stop, or what's going on? Maybe 2020 you get up and then things are making.
Is there a moon on the door?
I don't know. So maybe somebody can do something about
it. Our inspector's too busy bothering other people to finish up with some stuff that's already started.
Maybe you can do something about it. There's tourism coming.
It's been brought up to them.
It's a shame on town.
It's been brought up to them.
Whatever you want to talk about it, but it's. And who's doing that one that's, and later he's surprised because people hate it, but there isn't one.
Actually, Wes has been working on a change to our ordinance allowing 30 days or 60 days for commercial properties for demolition instead of the current 6 months. Because right now, if you get a permit, you can take a long time for demolition. But we're working on that.
You can get a few city people over here, put that things on a trailer and then pull it off. It looks like it was nice. Okay?
That actually came up a lot in meetings, is, you know, clean up the downhill of the city.
Okay. Other communication?
Yeah. I have a few comments about ordinance 2216, snow and ice removal ordinance. I was reading it in the paper. One of the things it says it must be removed in 2 hours of snowfall completion during daylight hours, probably 10 o'clock the following morning. But it's still snowing the following morning. It's not the best thing to do. It's still having to go out there and shovel. This is something we want to tell the residents of shoveling snow before the daylight came. I don't understand why the time constraint is 10 o'clock in the morning. Children, for the majority of the foot traffic in residential areas, are already in school by the day. So that doesn't make any sense. This also places a burden on those residents who actually work for it. Leaving home before daylight and returning after dark. I know many of my neighbors, I hear their car start up. It's not daylight yet. They don't come home right after dark. So when are they supposed to be? Supposed to take a day off? Doesn't seem like Christmas. Why are the streets not cleared on the same schedule? After all, the city has used the travel equipment purchased for the residents' tax money to do this test. Usually street snow relocation, I use that word because it's actually not removed, it's just relocated. It started long after the snow is packed in with icy sheet by morning traffic. It seems like another instance of government proceeding to do as I say, not as I do policy. Throughout the town, the existence of sidewalks is at best hit and miss in residential areas. Should residents be required to clear nick and pass between sidewalks? Are we only punishing those who are unfortunate enough to have a sidewalk? Are the sidewalks even required? If they are, why aren't they everywhere? Can residents remove them to reduce their maintenance requirements to match neighboring properties? Again, why are residents required to solve the sand at their own expense? When the city streets are not doing the same treatment, the only major thoroughfares can any salt or sand at their income. Snow removal from driving shall not be deposited on the street. Up when the snow plows relocate everything from the street onto the sidewalks and driveways, where residents are supposed to put this heavy wet mess. Those residents who work come home to this mess after dark, finding it frozen into a movable block across the driveways and sidewalks. That happened to me once. I couldn't even put the snow down where it was frozen. Who's responsible for clearing the alleyways when the snow plows? Deposit berms of snow from the street, which also covered the walking path road, and make access to residential off-street parking more difficult. As cars become smaller, the fuel economy and these berms rapidly become faster. Several of my neighbors park on the street all winter long because they can't get to the alley to get to an off-street parking in the back of their house. These berms across sidewalk approaches and alleyways also present an impassable option to our main residents and wheelchairs. I think we need a better, more equitable solution for the residents of our town.
Have I added this to our public safety agenda for the next meeting to look at ordinance and times for snow removal? Because it's not reasonable.
Okay, I just saw that and it was excessive. This is absolutely wrong. It's a purely ordinance.
That's the ordinance we have in place today, and I'm thinking we should make some changes to it.
Okay.
They'll take a look at it. Within probably a couple of weeks as well.
Okay.
who's supposed to clean sidewalks through the alleys? Is that the city or is that the homeowners on each side of the alley?
I can't remember what the ordinance says. Doesn't say anything about this. Doesn't say.
It does. We have to scoop our sidewalks and then there's sidewalk goes through the alley.
I think the city then would say.
Not so much the plow alleys, I guess.
I watch these people driving around down in the ditches here. The reason is, the first reason is almost none of the sidewalks are ADA compliant. I mean, absolutely, even downtown most of them are not ADA compliant. So they can't get those wheelchairs up and down over the curb and side. That's not.
Or they'll be taking a look at it personally.
Yeah, the only way they can get up is driving the coaches around.
Any other communication from the public?
Do we have a volunteer meeting for 6 o'clock lunch?
Oh, okay. All right. I'll be out of town myself. Okay, 6 o'clock lunch. All right. Thanks. Any other communication?
They put up a members' board just inside the door. And so any meetings or anything that members have, they put up on the board or replays.
Okay, thanks. Any other communication from the public? If not, we'll continue. We've got some personnel listed on your agenda. You can read that. New business, we will not have the plat approval. Next item is a travel request to go to the golf course meeting in Sioux Falls, a state meeting. This is a request for Jason to go. I entertain a motion for approval. Second. A motion and a second. Discussion or questions? Have a motion and a second to approve. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? No. Another travel request to go to the airport conference for, I think Ed Jensen and Denny Lewis are going, March 25th to 7th in Spearfish.
So moved.
There's a motion to approve that.
So moved.
Second. Have a motion, a second. Discussion or questions? Have a motion, a second for approval. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? No. And we've got a travel request for the building official to building official meeting in Rapid, March 25th. Have a motion and a second to approve. Discussion or questions?
So is this, does he learn something new, or is this just the same one every year? Is this, what does it cost?
Just costs us to, the registration is nothing on for this one. And it's exit requirements and ADA accessibility stuff that Ed was just talking about are the two programs that are on for the 25th in Rapid City.
Two things, city pickup?
Yes.
More questions or discussion? Motion, a second to approve. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? No. And we want to go out for maybe 3 water projects to be bid. Is that right, Dwight? I think you have a list of
2, possibly 3, and then we'd like one for the city crews to do too. 4th Street, Maine, water main from Detroit to Washington. 19th Street, Maine University to south of Detroit Street, and finish Albany from 21st to 24th Street. And the one for the city crews to do, we'd like to do Link Garden Street. There's a dead end on Garden Street by the bridge by Brookside, and there's a dead end front of the El Rancho apartments, and we'd like to hook them two together to alleviate freezing problems on the line by the Legion. So, them are the 4 we're looking at. City done, and three to go out for bid if the council so fails.
You're talking, that would be their whole next summer's project?
Yeah, if it goes good.
You don't think the city can do more than one?
Possibly. See, we got RV dump station put in, we got a couple houses to tear down. Things go good, yeah, possibly more. I'm thinking that if the city does some more, the water sewer department could do a few sewer lines that need replaced here in town too. And we're gonna be talking more about sewer lines at the next meeting, which ones we think should be changed out or the infrastructure added, because we have places in town that on septic systems right now that should be on the sewer line. Be easy fixes without tearing up asphalt or anything else. I'm talking about your workplace either. He gave you a funny look.
No, I'm looking at that guy about a sewer main that he's kind of dodging to stay at home. What's going on there? Are we doing it or we're not doing it, or?
We've requested the engineer for the state home to provide us the information that they have on the sewer line and the changes that have occurred, because they don't have to change the water line in an area that was going to affect the sewer. So there may not be a need for that sewer project to happen. But we haven't received any updated information on the bid that they requested several meetings ago or the changes that have been made.
We're still have projects in mind. It's always a summer too.
Yes. And that would be the street department. And these water replacements will come out of the water fund, which has a large sum of money in it now. We're hoping to keep a balance of around $1 million of emergencies in the water fund.
If you want to have an emergency, take $1 million.
We also don't know what's going to be dumped into that when they get started on the highway. So it's a good idea to make sure our bank is well kept until we know what we're doing there.
I don't feel like we should drain the fund, but we got quite a bit of money in there to do some of these projects.
So you're looking for a motion to proceed with three bids?
Yeah, I'll make the motion.
Second it.
Got a motion and a second to proceed with bidding three projects. More discussion, questions? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. And Fall River County accepted a little bid from Nelson's for diesel at $3.654, and for number two at $3.34. Committee reports. Did you have an administration meeting? Public Works, did you have anything else, Greg?
The vacant properties that will be starting to pay the minimum water bill, that has been implemented, and there's 47 bills going. Talked a little bit more about the water fill station, the new location, and bulk water rates. Kick that around again, but nothing concrete.
Okay. Thanks, Mike. Public safety, Fred, did you have a meeting?
No, but we're going to have a meeting, safety meeting next Monday at 8:00 or 9:00. But we're going to meet with FAA, they're going to call and have a conference call, but they're not going to do it next Monday, they're going to do it this week. And Ed's going to let us know when they can do it. And I'll let you guys know.
Okay.
I just found out this afternoon.
Cut into their vacation midweek?
All right. Good. Anything else, Craig?
Nothing.
Okay, thanks. And Wes, did you have anything from?
Nope.
Okay. Harley.
Just three real quick things. made mention a meeting or two ago about the heating system and the compressors in this building. They're over 20 years old and we're having some issues. The larger unit, $2,633 plus labor. The smaller unit's $1,100 plus labor. So we're looking at an expense that may or may not have already been done of $4,733 for the maintenance on the heating system for this facility. I just wanted to highlight the United Way program in the Southern Hills. Of course, everyone's aware of their activities. I think they met their goal for the year. So we have three employees that participated in the 2013-2014 United Way fundraiser through payroll deductions and other donations. I just wanted to highlight Don Johnson, Edith Cooper, and Tracy Bastion for their contributions to the United Way program. And just an informational item, Southern Hills Economic Development Company received a resignation letter from Clint Gregory, so there is an opening on the Southern Hills Economic Development Board of Directors. So if anyone's interested in being a member on the Economic Development Corporation for the Southern Hills, contact any of the board members or Cindy Turner, who is the executive secretary. That's everything I have, ma'am.
I have a question for Arlene. On our article this year, Arlene?
We're still working on it. There are three issues that we need to resolve as of yet on the audit.
I reviewed bills a few times when that lady was there and she wasn't happy whatsoever.
Now there's several, three areas in particular that we're not providing the documentation or the entries that she's required or would have liked to see. I just received an email from her over the weekend, and I've got the information that's, we met on Georgia and the mayor on Wednesday night with her for the, what referred to as the closeout audit. She provided the written comments of these three issues that she needs more information on, and then she provided nine other areas of items that she'd like to see us make changes in the accounting system.
Well, she made the comment to me, and I need you to tell me if it's true or not, that she ain't gonna do it no more for us.
That is correct. She took a job as a finance officer for Somerset. So she is no longer being an auditor and will be become a finance officer now.
It'll probably cost us
more. Well, probably, especially if we don't do it right. Might cost us a lot more.
Well, she won't be available. There's only one, maybe private one.
Okay, thank you, Arlen.
Thank you, Arlen.
I've got thank you notes from Prairie Hills Transit and from the Boys and Girls Club. If anybody wants to see them for donations to them that we included in the budget this year. And within the last 10 days or so, the House and the Senate in Pierre have passed a concurrent resolution making Hot Springs officially a veterans town. So we're now recognized by the state of South Dakota as a veterans town. And in your packet, we've got a policy, an administrative policy on nuisance property and on property maintenance. If you don't like the policy the way it is, as the council make some changes to it, because I don't care what it is, I just wanted something in writing because there was not an agreement between all the council on how we ought to do that. Some want it always in writing, some would say it doesn't have to be, so I don't care how this is, I just wanted something that we could follow. So make suggestions to this if you want, we'll change it.
Well, the thing is, you got to follow your current ordinance. You just can't pull an Obama and do an executive order. I mean,
I don't think anything in here is against an ordinance. It might be.
Well, it's pretty sketchy, I can tell you that. When you start putting in there, let's just get into it. Neighboring properties within a reasonable distance. What's reasonable? You got to have that set in stone. You can't just, well, that's that's reasonable.
And take a look at the ordinance.
I did.
Put something in the ordinance.
We'll review it.
Put something in the ordinance that says what we want then, because I don't know how else to do it myself. So anyway, this is in place until the council changes it, and I don't have a problem changing it. I just wanted you to know that. That's all that I have.
Any motions, Mr. Chair?
Got a motion by Commissioner Jordan?
Second.
Second? All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no? Thanks.